Alright, ref fam, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another Fantasy Draft Challenge episode. And I was actually going to record a Jackie Robinson debut. If you guys don't know, there's a Jackie Robinson that you guys can redeem for free. I have a whole video on that. But I don't like ranked season. I just don't enjoy ranked seasons anymore. There's no point in playing it. There's no point. Obviously, the only reason why I would play is for a debut. I don't know, man. If you guys want me to do a Jackie Robinson debut, let me know down in the comments down below. I will get it done if you guys want it to be featured on the channel. But today's episode, Fantasy Draft, and today's team, we're going to be focusing on the Boston Red Sox. A few of you guys did say the Boston Red Sox in the last episode, so I figured why not give them what they want, and let's go ahead and win ourselves the World Series. And all right, ladies and gentlemen, we get the 24th pick of the draft. Not the one that we want, obviously. Not the pick that we want, but the pick that we are given. And off the bat, Willie Mays sounds like a pretty good choice here. You got Babe Ruth, Ted Williams. We are going to get a choice, you know, a pretty close choice after this since we are the 24th pick. And I feel like we should be going with Mike Trout. Just get Mike Trout. He's usually very good in these modes. We're going to try to get Mike Trout and Ted Williams. Let's see if we can get Mike Trout and Ted Williams. So first pick, Mike Trout, welcome to the squad. And all right, the second pick we're going to choose, Ted Williams was literally, bro, they literally took Babe Ruth before this pick that we've got right now. So let's go ahead and choose Ted Williams and secure ourselves two brutal, nasty bats in the lineup, man. Let's do this. You got Nolan Arenado. You know what? Let's go ahead with Nolan Arenado. Yeah. We never choose Nolan Arenado that much. He did, you know, in the news as well. He got a $26 million in arbitration. So why not get Nolan Arenado? All right, folks, fourth pick of the draft. You know what time it is. Time to choose that pitcher that we want. And I feel like we have to go with Mad Max Scherzer to secure ourselves our rotation spot. Let's choose Sir Scherzer, man. Let's go. Jesse Orozco will be our pick for this one right here. We've never chosen him. Let's see what he does, man. Let's get straight to the team. And all right, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at our squad, and here we go. We got 99 Nomar Garciaparra, which actually makes sense because he did play with the Red Sox. We got Wade Boggs as well that played with the Red Sox. We got, wait a minute. Hold up. No, wait a minute. Wait. How did they just select all Red Sox for our squad? Yeah, you see, it selected an all-time team for each. I have never had this happen. I am so confused right now. You guys have no idea. But you know what? Let's roll with this. I guess we can actually roll with this. I don't know what happened, but I feel like we're gonna have to roll with this and kind of deal with this. We chose the what? But here we go, folks. We have one right over here. We're winning 6-2. David Ortiz they're trying to get us to get three home runs with him. I'm so lost. What the hell's going on? All right, so here we go. We got David Ortiz up on the play. I'm still kind of lost to what's happening, but I'm kind of just rolling with it. And yeah, let's see, man. This is definitely a big poppy type swing. We got Wade Boggs over at third, and let's see if, oh, can that drive him in? That is gonna drive him in. It doesn't score. Look at. What is that run? It doesn't score the run. I mean, it does score the run. It doesn't give us the home run, but it does score in the run. And all right, ladies and gentlemen, we do end up picking up the win. Obviously, with the score like that, we're going to get the win. 7-3. David Ortiz, 4-5. An absolute monster, man. Let's go. Okay, you know what? This might actually not be a bad idea. This could actually be kind of a series on its own where we draft, where we kind of get like the all-time team of a certain franchise. And we can actually do some work with this. So it's not really a bad idea, to be honest with you guys. Not a bad idea. The only thing I see is that we probably won't be able to need to make any trades, I would think. Because we would already have all the players that we would want. A lot of good players. You could argue that we could probably make some move in the bullpen. And we'll just see how the season goes. We'll probably make some moves in the bullpen. And we're not going to do this trade here. So let's go ahead and continue on with the season, folks. We're doing pretty good. I would expect the Red Sox all-time team to do pretty good, honest, because it is the all-time Red Sox team. And all right, ladies and gentlemen, we have made some moves in the rotation. First of all, we signed Tug McGraw. Have not seen him signed onto a team, into one of our teams. So I figured why not just sign Tug McGraw. We also picked up Will Harris and David Robertson. And I feel like now with these additions, the team is going to look amazing. All right, 59-33. The Yankees are actually closing in on us. We're kind of slowing down. Michael Chavez is apparently the leadoff hitter for us. Fuck's sakes. Ted Williams, slow it down. Big Poppy, you already know Big Poppy doing Big Poppy type things. And we do need a catcher. We actually do need a catcher because this is not going to work out at all. All right, so we have now picked up our catcher. And our catcher is going to be Wilson Contreras. I decided on Wilson Contreras. He's having himself a really good season. And I figured, why not? He's, like I said, having a really good season. What is the point of actually taking him out? So we added him in, and Nomar Yastrzemski is on the, I don't know why he's on the bench. Yikes, man. Yikes. It's time for us to make a run. We now have a secured catcher. It's time to see if we are able to make it farther into the league and see if we can potentially win the World Series with one of the best teams in the history of baseball. This is technically one of the greatest teams in baseball history, one of the greatest franchises, I should say, in all of baseball. So it'll be nice to see if we'll be able to pick up a World Series trophy with them and make it just the second ever time we ever win a World Series trophy with a team. So at 72-38, I'm really confident that we're gonna be making it into the postseason, and we might as well just start simulating over to the end of the season, honestly. Wow. So ladies and gentlemen, we've tanked it at 102 wins and 60 losses. We managed to only make it to the wild card to face off against the Oakland, to face New York. That is actually quite sad. So these are the injuries that we have acquired. Wade Boggs, a huge loss to the team. Wade Boggs led the league and basically for the entire year in batting average, David Ortiz in hits, Ted Williams in runs scored, and in base on balls. So that's pretty interesting. And awards, American League MVP goes to David Ortiz. You got Carl Yastrzemski with the Gold Glove. And that's pretty much it, folks. And I don't know what's going on. I don't know what the hell's going on. I don't know why we're not getting the results that we should be getting. But hey, who am I to judge? So let's go ahead. And we're gonna quick play this one real quick. We're not gonna commentate everything by what it is, stuff like that. We're not gonna commentate every single thing. We're just gonna quick manage this thing. Just literally quick manage it. And we're gonna actually Roger Clemens. We're gonna actually use Pedro Martinez. And we're gonna put the lineup set like this. I feel like this is the best lineup possible that we can actually use. We'll put Pedroia in here. And yeah, let's go ahead and play ball, folks. Let's go ahead and see what we can do here. Already off to a horrible start against the A's. And if we don't make it, a triple scores in two runs, nice. If we don't make it, this is going to be very disappointing. Just for the fact that, we were in first place for a large portion of the season. And then we just don't do anything about it. And it's just sad. But we do have a 5-2 lead over on Oakland. And let's see if we can maintain this lead and try to keep the main man, Pedro Martinez, on the mound for the longest time possible. And at 7-2, I think we can safely leave him there for the meantime. We don't want to use up our bullpen for this time, because all right, Contreras with the solo bomb, and I feel like this just secured ourselves a spot, and we do end up beating the Athletics, a score of 8-2. Benintendi 3 RBIs and 2 runs. And let's go ahead and simulate this, folks. And we're gonna play the last game. All right, this is basically for all the marbles here. Yankees and Red Sox, the classic, the duel of titans. We're going to put Roger Clemens up on the mound. And this is how the lineup is going to play out, folks. This is how we're going to be able to try to see if we can defeat the Yankees. Going to be a hard feat, but let's see if we can do it, folks, with the main man, Severino up on the mound for them. A single. We do score a run. And Joe DiMaggio already with the... Okay. I mean, this is probably the hardest team we've ever we're gonna have to face, the Yankees. So, yeah. Interesting to see how this will play off, man. Interesting to see how this will play with, you know, just down by two. Not too bad. All right, just down by one now. A ground out. Who the fuck just hit a home run for the Yankees? I have no idea who that guy is, folks. But it's looking bad, man. Looking bad. Down 4-2 on the last game. They do score another. Wow, bro. Are you serious? Fuck, man. How are we not able to make it far in the postseason with one of the best teams in baseball? With the Boston Red Sox, we're not able to make it far to the postseason. And it looks like we're going to be eliminated by them. And that's going to be a shitty, shitty feeling. Unless we do something here. Wilson Contreras strikes out and a fly out. Bases loaded. One out. We do nothing about it, folks. That's another walk run. Oh, my God, man. This is terrible. This is absolutely frustrating. We get eliminated by the Yankees, man. Ah, the Yankees eliminate us from the postseason. I don't understand. Look at this. Close games once again that we could potentially win. Nothing happens, folks. But let's go ahead and simulate the rest of the postseason and see who does win. And the would you look at that? The Yankees defeat the Cubs in the World Series. Honestly, the Yankees were the most powerful team besides us in this entire thing here. So, yeah, that's going to be the episode right there, folks. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed, man. If you guys enjoyed it, please make sure to leave a like down below. If you guys want to see your team featured in the next episode, make sure to comment down the team down below. And I'll make sure to get them done ASAP for you guys. It's been your boy Rezzy, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. When I pull up, you can't see any. Too many bitches just wanna be my lady.